So you think you're actually making progress with your anxiety. You're doing a few things correctly and you feel good and you're like, okay, I got the hang of this. And then all of a sudden, your anxiety hits you like a train. And you thought you were making progress. You thought maybe you could even get out of this. And all of a sudden, it hits you and it just reminds you that maybe this is a life sentence. Maybe you can't get out of this. What I want to talk about is what you're really experiencing. It's something that we call setbacks. And it's actually part of the anxiety recovery. And it's actually one of the reasons why a lot of people aren't able to make full recovery. And so if you can learn how to overcome setbacks and really understand what's happening, the good news is that you'll keep progressing. And you'll progress so much that you eventually fully overcome. So pay attention and I'm gonna show you exactly how to overcome setbacks once and for all. So let's get started. First and foremost, if you've actually experienced a setback, a true setback, congratulations. Because the truth is you can only have a setback if you're actually making progress. See, most people think a setback is where, you know, you have some good days and then you have some bad days and they classify the bad days as a setback. That's not true. A true setback is you're actually making progress. You're actually able to maybe even see the light at the end of the tunnel. And all of a sudden, anxiety hits out of nowhere. And all the progress you made, it feels like it just comes tumbling down. It's like you're climbing a mountain and then you just fall. But in the beginning, a lot of times people don't really experience that because every day is kind of a bad day, so they don't really experience a setback. So it's really important to understand that setbacks aren't just something that happen in recovery, they're actually expected. Most people have the wrong idea of how anxiety recovery looks like. A lot of times they'll think anxiety recovery is like a broken bone, where if you just put a cast on it, it just heals, it heals, it heals until it's fully healed and you take the cast off and then you're good. Recovery with anxiety is actually not like that. It's often 3 steps forward, 2 steps back. It's kind of like you make progress and then the anxiety hits you a little bit harder. And then you make a little bit more progress and the anxiety hits. But the overall trend is that the anxiety gets less and less. And that if you could just focus on how to overcome setbacks, well, the setbacks over time don't hit you as hard. So in order to understand how to overcome setbacks, well, you really have to ask yourself, how are you overcoming anxiety? If you can focus on anxiety and focus on the principles of anxiety, you can use those same principles towards setbacks. And so if you're trying to know, okay, well, how do I overcome anxiety? How do I know if I'm doing it correctly? What I'll do is I'll put a link down below. This is a link that exactly shows you step by step on really how to overcome anxiety. This is exactly what I've done to help several people fully get out of it and also something that my own life depended on. So I'm going to put a link down below. So this is a report that shows you exactly step by step on how to get out of this. Now, this has been field tested constantly. Everybody that goes through my mentorship, everyone has to go through these steps. These steps have to work for everybody. And these same steps actually worked for me, otherwise I'd be stuck watching these videos trying to figure out how do I overcome anxiety, how do I overcome setbacks. So if you really want to know if you're overcoming setbacks correctly, I'll put a link down below. Check out that report, read through it. Once you understand how to overcome anxiety, I'll show you exactly how to use that towards overcoming setbacks. So in order to overcome setbacks, like I say, you have to understand that setbacks are part of the recovery journey. It's actually expected. And it's something that you should look towards because that means you're going the right direction. The second thing is, do you understand how to overcome anxiety? A lot of it is understanding what's happening to you, allowing, accepting, moving forward. Now, the third thing to really focus on is consistency. See, what happens is that when there's not that much anxiety or anxiety is kind of good and you know it's not as intense, it's really easy to accept. It's really easy to allow. However, when the anxiety gets really hard, that's where it counts. And what most people end up doing is that when things are good, they're fine, they'll allow and accept. But the second anxiety comes up, they gotta go back into fix-it mode. Why am I experiencing this? Why is this happening to me? Oh, I thought I was doing well. Oh my God, I'm not making any progress. I feel like I'm back at square one. And what happens is that they end up self-sabotaging. So how do you get through setbacks? Well, you get through setbacks the same way you get through a good day, which is consistency. You need to respond to the anxiety regardless of how intense it is. So whether you're experiencing a full-blown setback where 20 of your symptoms disappeared and all of a sudden came back, or whether you're only experiencing 2 out of the 20 symptoms, the reaction needs to be the same, which is you allow, you accept it, and the quicker you accept the setback, the faster it actually ends up going away. And the truth is that the next time it comes, it hits you with less intensity. Over time, as you progress, the difference between a setback and a good day is gonna be so thin because the setbacks just don't hit you as hard. So it's really important to focus on consistency. Now, I get it, consistency is the hardest part. It's really hard to do this all on your own because, well, you've never had to do something like this before. So are you going the right direction? Are you not? You always have to check in. Okay, well, am I going the right direction? And you're always trying to analyze where you are in the recovery journey. If you really want to get this problem fixed once and for all, and just have somebody just take you by the hand and just take you to recovery himself or herself, what I can do is I put a link down below to my mentorship. I have a small group of individuals that I'm personally taking by the hand and I'm taking them to full recovery. I'm making sure they get out of this once and for all. I'm not interested in them making them feel a little bit better. I'm interested in them fully getting out of this once and for all. So if that's you, hit the link down below. When you hit the link, you have to watch a video that gives you really great insight actually about what's happening, and then it'll lead to an application. You fill out that application, my team and I will review it, and if you're a good fit, we'll schedule a call with you to really see how we can kind of help you get to your goals, help you get to fully overcome, so that you can really enjoy the life that you want without dealing with setbacks, without dealing with anxiety, where you could just hang out in the day, have a good time with your friends, with your family. This is a chapter closed, and you never have to worry about this again. So if that's you, hit the link down below, and hopefully I'll talk to you soon.